People get a little on edge when guys smile silently at them in here.
I never know what to say at this point. I want to ask how you're doing or something like that, but it seems ridiculous when the answer's obviously not good.
I'd watch it if I were you. Now look here. If I get one more hint of pity out of you, I'm gonna have one of these monkey boys haul me out of here. Do you understand?
I wasn't pitying you. I was trying to talk to you.
Don't come in here thinking you can fix me, cause there ain't nothing wrong. The fuck you! I may be in here with a bunch of murderers and thieves, but at least I ain't holding their fucking hands on the outside. You enjoying being a wet nurse for a bunch of ex-cons? Yeah. Doesn't feel so good when I pity you, does it? You remember that the next time you're babysitting those cocksuckers who weasel their way back into that cancer you call society?
You're ashamed of the guys that make it out of here?
Oh, shit. They don't get out just because they done their time. They get out early because they grovel for the warden and the parole board. They fucking rat on their brothers inside just so they can get out and have you whisper in their ear. And they get a janitorial job and a crappy apartment.
So you never want to get out?
Don't be a fucking idiot. I'll get out, but it'll be on my own terms. See, this is a men's prison, boy, for real men who know how to act that way.
And that's worth being locked up? Instead of being out there with your loved ones? Your brotherhood. You have a real family too, remember?
Please stop. You're making me cry.
Hey, I'll give you a better name than brotherhood. How about a camaraderie amongst professionals?
What, professional prisoners?
Oh, make it sound like being out there is some kind of paradise. Even if it means shitting your pathetic life away in psychology classes. Where did that get you?
A worthless warehouse job, which you barely hung on to till you took to being a counselor for criminals.
I stopped trying to impress you a long time ago, okay?
Huh? Good. What are you doing here, boy?
I wanted to give you a chance. One last chance before I, you know.
Before what?
You finally gonna stop seeing your old man?
No, I'll keep seeing you, Dad. That's not gonna change. But how things play out from now on? I just wanted to give you one last chance. Seems only fair.
You still want to know why, don't you? I chose to take my life back. See, I lived outside these walls, but I let your mother infect me with her disease. And I forgot what it meant to be a man. So I took the necessary steps to get it back. Take notes, frat boy. This is important. Step one, I got out of my job. Step two, I got an alternative source of income. Step three, I escaped that suffocation that was you and your mother. And step four, I've been able to live my life on my terms ever since.
And what? Step five is your... spending the rest of your adult life rotting in prison?
Oh, you learned that smart mouth shit from your mother, didn't you? Well, this is the last time you're gonna pull this stunt on me, see? Because I don't have to come to these visits if I don't want to. Next time I see you sitting here when I round that corner, I'm marching straight back to my cell. My terms, boy, not yours.
Just so you're in the loop. This isn't some kind of conjugal visit. Show up. accepting with my life. I've known what I've wanted to be now for a very long time, thanks to you. I've lost you. Well, let me run it down for you in simple steps, since I know you like that kind of thing. Step one, I shit my time away getting a psychology degree. Two, I aimlessly wandered into that warehouse where I was fairly promptly made the boss, acquired various management skills, and then, and apparently, what has you upset most? Step three, I became a probation officer. Spent my days helping ex-cons keep their second chance at life.
And what, smartass? Step five is when I get released into your custody? Wouldn't that just make your day? You like reversing roles, don't you, boy? You think we could finally have that father and son dream? You know, play catch in the backyard? Maybe go for a beer at the bar together after... No, we couldn't do that. We couldn't drink together, see? Because that would be violating my probation. So much for that.
Gosh, Dad. Fooled my plan. Except... I'll be long retired by the time you're a free man. And you skip step four. Step four was when I left my job as a probation officer. And I went back to school.
You're obsessed. Get a fucking life.
Yeah, I went back and I got a criminology degree.
I take it back. You're obsessed with me.
Well, they do say the best cowboys have daddy issues.
You're a weak. Just like your mother. You'll never make the rules. You think you can control someone like me? Your mother tried that and look where it got her. I didn't have to sit there and take it then, and I don't have to now. You're just like your fucking mother. Why don't you join her?
Well, I have to be like one of my parents. I'm not gonna argue with you there.
So I guess you are my inspiration, Dad. You helped me choose what I wanted to do with myself. For the people on the outside, in the world of grown-ups, who want to keep selfish pieces of shit like you out of their lives. Sit down.
Now those five steps wind up with me becoming the assistant warden at SCI Green. See, it's a real man's job that requires actual skill, like accounting and administrating and making decisions about people like you. Now, I may never be the warden of your prison, but I play golf with them. It's amazing what a little camaraderie amongst professionals can do. You would have thought that having a father in prison would have hurt my chances of getting this gig. But it's a surprisingly common trait in this field. You know, like my friend, your warden, always says, the best cowboys have daddy issues. So I'll be seeing you, Dad. Drop in on you every once in a while. Tuck you in at night. And just really admire this great life you've made for yourself. Maybe even remake parts of it for you, too. But mostly, I'm gonna keep coming back because I remind you of Mom. Family. And you have to return to your cell. And the servitude. And the 20 years of getting fucked by a hairy, jobless excuse for a man. Just like